Hey guys, so in this video I want to show you the campaign structure that delivered $793,000 in sales. You can see here, delivered that with $200,000 in advertising spent with 3.85 return on ad spend. You can see here, this is the ad account, right? And the strategy that I'll share with you will apply for the e-commerce entrepreneurs who are like having like general stores. It will apply for people who have niche stores. You can take the same framework and apply it for your own particular niche. Here you can see majority of the campaigns that we have. These are CBO campaigns, right? So in terms of the like naming conventions, like when you have, let's say, like a general store, right? And that's a mistake that I see a lot of entrepreneurs are making. They don't have like a proper naming for their campaigns, right? So for example, they don't have the campaign name, they don't have the particular break-even ROAS or break-even CPA that they need to hit for that campaign to be profitable or at least like break-even. They kind of like have all of this like random, you know, information here, right? So for us, like, we use a specific naming convention. I'll show you now in a second that we use to basically have all of the changes and everything like laid out very carefully so that we can easily identify what's working specifically in that account and what doesn't work, right? The campaign naming. So for example, product name. So what is the name of the product? Whether you're running like a niche store or you're running the store that has like multiple products, like a general store, you always need to have like product name, right? Then for us, we always optimize the landing pages. We always have few variations of the landing pages, especially in the testing phase for each of the stores that we are launching. So we'd have like different variations. For example, if you use like version one of the landing page, right? So you specify which is version, maybe who created that on your team, and you would have that here. Then the price, how much is the price for the product? How much you sell it for? Because maybe you are testing different price points, right? And you just wanna see what's more profitable for you. Then the break-even ROAS, for example, in this case, like 1.6, right? So you'd have the break-even ROAS here so you can easily identify, let's say if on a campaign level, campaign performs at like 1.5 and break-even ROAS, you can see very quickly this like 1.6, you can quickly identify that the campaign has specific issue and then you go inside and investigate what is happening there. Maybe that's creative, maybe that's the ads, maybe just, you know, the ads don't get delivered because they're not competitive, the click rate. So you kind of like start investigating, but it's very easy for you to read, especially if you have multiple products running from the same ad account. And then maximum cost per purchase. So if you're optimizing for a cost per purchase or it's kind of like some benchmark that you're aiming for, then you would have here the benchmark. Then on the ad set level here, you can see I would have like country, for example, what countries you are targeting, gender, age, interest, placements, and bid. I mean, placements and bids we typically just keep automated and we keep it just very simple. We try not to complicate that. In terms of the interest, so you would specify like which interest you're testing, and then you would specify what is the age you're targeting and like what is the gender. So again, it all comes down to for you or your like media buyers, your team members to quickly log in into the account, quickly evaluate the performance of the campaigns, also quickly identifying what exactly is working well, or maybe there's like some issues that need to be fixed. So then you just know exactly, okay, so we have a problem like with this age range, we have the problem with this targeting option. So then you go ahead and just fix it. On the ad level, right? So you have like the image, video, name, maybe the creative that you source from someone, right? Maybe the testimonial set, maybe the, you know, like maybe some content creator that you hired, maybe some company that you hired to produce a content. So you'd have it here, like image, video, name. Then you would have like the thumbnail. Maybe you're testing different thumbnails. Again, maybe you're sourcing them from someone. So now this, like these naming conventions, I'll show you in a second how to like basically streamline that inside of the Ads Manager. So you would have it all like named properly. Again, for a quick analysis of the information, quick analysis of the data. So when you log in, let's say like within 2 minutes, you know exactly what's happening in that account, whether you're profitable or not, and what exactly you know, needs your attention, right? So I'll show you now like how to use the name conventions, how to streamline that with Facebook. Make sure, guys, that it's like first it's available to you, because you can see here that it's not available to all advertisers. When you go here, like you have your you can see like you have like pretty much a simple, like very simple process to just create ads as usual, and then find it campaign name, ad set name, or ads a name field, and switch to the name template, toggle in the position, it will turn blue, right? So it basically should be available within your ads manager. So when you create like an ad set, or like you choose one of your like existing campaigns to continue with it, then it will give you this option to apply this template. So all of these things that I showed you guys, for example, you can just do more like in a more like streamlined way, right? So for example, this country names, gender, like, so all of this can be streamlined and can be more efficient. So you can name your campaigns properly, and you can name them pretty much so you can quickly analyze the data. Now, in terms of campaign structure rules, so you can see a lot of these are CBOs. The budget that currently works for us, like it ranges from $250 to $650 in this particular store. Like in other ad accounts, we get pretty good results with even higher budgets. We get like $1,000, even $1,500 CBOs. They're working quite well. Now you have to identify like your sweet spot for you specifically. So for example, we are mostly focusing on higher ticket items, and that predicates what is the budget, right? So for example, if we have the budget of like $1,500 per day on one of these campaigns, then it's pretty much like you have only, let's say $1,500, but cost per purchase, let's say $50, right? So it's like 30 purchases per day, right? But let's say if your desired cost per purchase $10, then you can do like only $200-$300 and you'll have like the same amount of conversion. So let me know if that makes sense in the comments, guys. But basically that's how it's structured. So the budget that you need to hit for the CBOs will be predicated by your product cost and kind of like whether your product high ticket or not. So you have to test with it and find the sweet spot. Also, don't push something over the edge. Like let's say you, $500, you're doing pretty well, then don't push it to like $1,000, $1,500, $2,000 if it's not performing well for you, right? Like just do things that specifically work well for you. So in terms of the ad set level, I mean, these are all like very simple, like CBOs, guys. So there is nothing like very complicated here. You can see with us, like one of the ad sets didn't work out, so we had to turn it off. Basically the ads that are working, they just like broad targeting. They have only a gender country. The structure is very simple, and you can see that on the ad level, there are like different variations of the ads. So that's pretty much how it is structured, right? So we typically would have at least 4 variations of the ads. In some cases, we'd have like even like 20, 30 ads per ad set, and just like let Facebook identify the best ad to show to the people. In terms of campaign structure, because I see a lot of people, they're making this like mistake. Let me see, this is the best tool. All right, so let's say you have like campaign, then let's say you have your, this is the ad set, right? And these are the ads, right? Like, let's make it this way. So let's make it more square. Let's do it more square here. You can see here, or let's do it this way. So campaign, ad set, ad, right? So a lot of people, they would just, and now I see that like very often, like they would see like, they would have like many, many ad sets, right? They have like micro budget. Like, I mean, I don't know who taught people this stuff, but it's just like, doesn't make sense. People get their account shut down like with $5 ad set, $10 ad set, but some people would have like many, many duplicates. So they would have like these ad sets, let's say $5-$10, and then would create like duplicates like 50-100 times to kind of like spend more, right? On our side, what we are trying to do is we're trying to have less campaigns, right? We're trying to have less ad sets, as I showed you. For example, in some cases we have only like 1, 2, 3 ad sets. This is it. We try to keep it very simple. Try to kind of like just, I mean, open up as much as possible, right? And have it very simple. So some of these are broad audience work very well for us, guys. Then on that level, on the ad level, we'd have many ads, right? So we'd have we would have like many ads, like we'd have at least four, but in most cases like 6, 8, 10 ads, right? So you can see how it's structured, right? So where most people try to do is something like this, right? Like many, many of these, and then they would only have like, I don't know, 1, 2 ads, right? Our structure, and that's what allows us to scale much better, is to have basically less ad sets, but more ads, right? And less campaigns. The simpler you keep it, the better. Now, obviously, if you have different products, you always have to segment it, like to kind of like track it better and stuff like that. But this is overall the structure that you have to keep. Like, if you're trying to do it like other way, I mean, it might work for you, but it won't be scalable. And once you start spending, let's say, you know, $3,000-$5,000 a day. So let's say you have like $5 ad sets, right? So if you want to spend, let's say, like $5,000 a day, how many ad sets you need for that, right? Like, let's do like a quick calculation, like 1,000 ad sets. Can you imagine like managing 1,000 ad sets? It's just like ridiculous. So, or even like $10, I mean, you still have like 500 ad sets, which is still like too much. So what you can do is actually have like less ad sets, right? Try to, obviously try to push the budgets here on the campaign level of this like CBO as much as possible, because then you have, you know, less complexity within your ad account, and you can pretty much just spend more with less complexity. But at the same time, guys, like out of all of this, right? Out of all of these parts, the creative part is the number one, right? It's number one important, because I mean, you can have your broad targeting, you can have your like very just random, easily create like campaign. But then if your creative is strong, then you'll just do very well, right? And by strong creative, I mean the creative that gets like good click-through rate, that gets like decent cost per click, right? Ideally below $1, and that actually converts, right? I mean, that's the most, like number one thing is that like actually converts. So getting like, you know, 3-5% conversion, that's the number one thing. If it doesn't convert, then it is a problem, right? Like, I mean, these metrics can be like, you can have like click rate of like 5%, then you can have like CPC of like less than $1. But if it doesn't convert, it doesn't matter. Having all of this, like, you know, just take this into consideration and focus most of your attention here on the creative, how you communicate the product, how you communicate the value of the product, whether you cover the main benefits, the problem solving features of the product, and whether that value of the product is more than customers actually pay for it. So this is it, guys. This is the campaign structure. Obviously, it's like very like simplified way that put it together for you guys. If you want like more detailed, and if you want like more personalized and more like advanced strategies, then there should be a link below this video. You should apply for our community and program, E-commerce Scaling Secrets. We are helping entrepreneurs to scale their e-commerce businesses, and specifically those entrepreneurs who already have traction with their businesses. If you do like $1,000 a day or like $5,000 a day and you want to take it to the next level, and also be in the community of entrepreneurs that are doing very well, just to know like what's happening in the place, because the place, you know, the space is changing like very dynamically, then you should apply for a program. It's not for everyone. It's only for people who are ready to grow, who are ready to invest into their business to grow faster, and just take it to the next level. So for everyone, I mean, this is pretty much the framework that you can use, and you can take it as is. Just apply to your business, use these like naming conventions, just comment conventions, and I'll drop these as a comment for you guys, conventions in the comments, and I'll drop these in the comments for you like personally, and then you can just take it from there and implement it on your side and start scaling your business. So this is it, guys. Thank you very much. Like this video, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you guys in the next one.